So I came for surgery. I went through outpatients. I did my 7 pages of writing down my allergies. Made it very clear to the nurse there that it's so important that the staff knows about these allergies because they're all life-threatening. And we did the surgical checklist, and I met the doctor, and we're all good until I'm laying on the table and my arm's stretched out and I'm kind of strapped down, and I hear the nurse in the corner going, "Doctor, we have the heparin all ready for the new port." Well, with that, my head goes up and I said, "We're going to stop because I'm very allergic to heparin, and obviously someone has not read my chart." And with that, I stopped the line. So I'm very proud of myself.
If safety is something we do and is the lens we put on every day when we come to work, as opposed to just managing incidents, managing concerns, managing behavior, it really has to be something that permeates everything we do. So we started to look at how do staff report. And what we started to see was we heard from the staff, okay, an incident happens, now I have to think, is it the false form I fill out? Is it the medication form I fill out? Is it the AIMS report I fill out? Is it the OH&S? And you started to see how complex we had made our system.
So I'm Evelyn Soulier from
Saskatoon Health Region wasn't the only region in the province with a complex safety reporting system.
And we do hear from our staff. They are very frustrated. They submit these reports. They're very passionate, and they don't hear back. What was the outcome?
Our system is a paper-based system, and I think one of the biggest challenges with it is that it's retrospective. We're always looking back.
I don't want to put a really strong...
The groups broke into teams and worked out what the ideal future state of a safety alert system would look like, from alert to triage to response. The teams then shared ideas on how patients, families, and employees could access the system, and they discussed what features it should have.
We wanted to have different access options, so either texting, internet, or kind of like a panic button. We were thinking of like a 911 number for timely action and response. We'd like a case tracking number as well.
What happened?
By combining the best features from each team, the group creates a draft map of the ideal future state.
So a safety alert pamphlet was provided to everybody coming into the system. Patient, family, or staff, etc., had the ability to identify a trigger that may consider that there's a safety issue. That trigger could be something they've seen, something they've heard, something they've smelt, something they've felt. From there, we believed that this system allowed anybody to speak up and seek action.
Yes, that does, I think.
However, by the end of day two, the challenges facing the group become overwhelming.
Day two is a little bit more confusing because we're breaking off into our teams and on a specific work area. And I think I'm confused, everyone's confused about the specifics of it.
I agree with that. I heard lots of times groups saying we got stuck here because we didn't know where we could go.
Now today we're working on the detail of those processes. How do we actually create the standard work? Who will do it? What do they do? What materials or equipment would they need?
As Wacky Wednesday wears on, the team struggles with figuring out the detailed logistics and standard work around the process map they've created.
I just struggle with that part of the conversation because I thought that was one of our premises and one of our foundations was one-stop shop. And I really thought that's why we came here this week. And I really don't want to leave this week with anything other than one-stop shop.
We just keep having to come back to, you know, the patients and families and our staff who we want to make sure we keep safe every single day. So I think that keeps us grounded all the time in doing the hard work and the uncomfortable conversations.
Okay, good morning, everyone. We're going to get started.
Oh, I thought this was my manager. My floor manager, the nurse man, are you on our unit? We aren't calling for any help. Stay in the coffee room.
Teams are given a safety situation to simulate. In this case, a medication error has been made, and the team has to act out how they would respond to the alert.
2,600 milligrams of Dilantin was drawn into a 60 mil syringe and infused via syringe pump to the patient. Oops.
They begin to run through the simulation and realize that there's still much work to be done, but the role play has been useful in discovering where the gaps in the process are.
Any input is helpful. Event or trigger.
Once the simulations are over, the team takes another look at the final future state map.
Do I have the option to stop the line? So this might mean I'm a patient and I am laying on the bed like Heather talked to us about, and I'm too scared to tell the team that I'm scared. So no, I don't have the option. I'm going to call the safety center. Or it might
by the end of day four, it feels like all the pieces are coming together, and there's a sense of relief among the team members.
It was awesome. It was awesome. I was very nervous coming in, and before lunch, I was panicking, and after lunch, I feel totally like we've got it nailed.
The fact that we have a clear flow on our process map and standard work to go with most of all of our pieces, I think that's really amazing that we're there today.
Yeah. I think it really came together today after feeling quite disorganized earlier in the week. I think, too, to see the level of relief on other people's faces, and you know, there's a lot to be said for those conversations that happen around the water cooler and the coffee pot, and those conversations have had a lot better flavor this afternoon, so it's good stuff.
It's a monumental task when you look at the complexities of all the systems that were involved, and the right people were here, and to see them all drawing on their skill sets and apprehensions they had earlier in the week all seemed to be overcome, and they began working together as this team that developed this excellent response system that's just going to be really exciting to see it roll out.
And I would echo what Shelley said. I think the passion in the groups was awesome because it continued right through coffee and lunch, and the conversation about the system never stopped. It continued all day and is still happening now.
We can't get people to leave.
I didn't realize there'd be people here from all the different regions, but I think it's excellent that is a component of this, because it's so easy to get focused on your own hospital, on your own region, and not realizing that this impacts a whole province. So I think for me that was a big eye-opening experience.
There have been efforts to implement in the past. This is just developing a system to bring something to fruition that we've hoped would exist. And staff buy-in is going to be the biggest key. If they don't buy it, we're going to flounder.
I also had confidence that if you put a good mix of people in the room who have a common purpose, that magic happens. And so I was pretty confident we would do something special this week, because there's a sense of pride and a sense of ownership. And I think that's one of the things that's special about this 3P. We've had people from across the province, especially we've had several patient advisors. And I think collectively the wisdom and the hard work and the commitment will come through in the report out. I think what we'll see is that we set the stage for the work ahead, but there's a ton more work to be done before we implement the first example, the first model line of our new safety alert stop the line system for Saskatchewan.